So let me briefly introduce you the idea of cache-aware scheduling when you have these multi-threaded, multi-core processors. And to make things concrete, let's assume that you have a pool of ready threads. And in this case, I'm going to tell you that the pool of ready threads I have is 32. So I have 32 ready threads, and I have a four-way multi-core CPU, meaning that there are four cores in the CPU, and each core is four-way hardware multi-threaded. Or in other words, at any point of time, the operating system can choose from this pool of ready threads 16 threads to be run on the processor. Because that's the number of hardware multi-threads that are available if you pool together all the four cores. So each core has four hardware multi-threads. Together, they have 16 hardware threads that can be run on the CPU at any point of time. And the job of the operating system scheduler is to pick from the available pool of ready threads 16 candidates to be scheduled on the CPU. So how does the operating system choose the 16 threads to be run on the CPU at any point of time? What the operating system should try to do is it should co-schedule some number of cache-frugal threads and some number of cache-hungry threads on the different cores so that together the sum of all the cache hungriness of the 16 threads that are executing at any point of time in the CPU is less than the total size of the L2 cache. And as I said, L2 cache, in this simple example, I gave you two levels of caching that is associated with each of these cores, and an L2 cache that is sitting outside of this cores, but it is common to all the four cores. But of course, you can generalize this and say it is a last level cache. Or in other words, you want to make sure that the universe of threads that are scheduled at any point of time on the CPU, the sum total of the cache requirements of the universe of threads scheduled on the processor is less than the total capacity of the last level cache in the CPU. Because if you're missing the last level cache on the CPU, you're going outside the chip, out to memory, long latency operation, bad news. That's the thing that you're trying to do. So we're going to characterize threads as either cache frugal threads or cache hungry threads. So cache frugal threads are ones that require only a small portion of the cache to keep them happy. On the other hand, a cache hungry thread is one that requires a huge amount of cache space in order to keep it happy, meaning that the working set of cache-hungry threads is much bigger than the working set of the cache-frugal threads. Now, how do we know which threads are cache-frugal and which threads are cache-hungry? Well, that's something that we can know only by profiling the execution of the threads over time. So the assumption is that many of these threads get to run on the CPU over and over again. So over time, you can profile these threads and figure out whether a particular thread belongs to this category of cache frugal thread or this category of cache hungry thread. And the criterion that you want to use in picking the set of threads to be populated in the CPU at any point of time from the pool of available threads is to make sure that the sum of the cache requirement of all the cache frugal threads, if there are n cache frugal threads and there are m cache hungry threads, then the cumulative cache requirement of all the threads put together is less than the total size of the L2 cache. And as I told you, we can generalize this L2 cache to the last level cache, that is the cache that is sitting at the last level inside the CPU, beyond which you have to go out of the chip, go out to memory. And so that last level cache becomes the determinant in saying whether the size of the last level cache is within bounds of the cache requirements of all the threads that I want to schedule. So this is the set of threads that I want to pick, where in this particular case, since the total number of hardware threads that I have available to me is 16, I want to make sure that M, the cache-hungry threads, N, the cache-frugal threads, is 16, and this inequality is satisfied as well. So that's what we want to shoot for in picking the set of threads to run on the processor at any point of time. I mentioned that we have to profile these threads or monitor these threads as they're executing in order to figure out their cache occupancy over time so that we can categorize these threads as cache frugal or cache hungry. And the more information the scheduler has, the better decision it can take in terms of scheduling. But you have to be careful about that. In order for the system to do this monitoring and profiling, clearly the operating system has to do some work in the middle of these threads doing useful work. And I've always maintained that a good operating system gives you the resources that you need and gets out of the way very quickly. And so you have to be very careful about the amount of time that the operating system takes in terms of doing this kind of monitoring and profiling. And this information is useful in scheduling decisions, but it should not be disrupting useful work that these guys have to do in the first place. In other words, the overhead for information gathering has to be kept minimal so that the OS does not consume too many cycles in doing this kind of overhead work, accounting for making better decisions in terms of scheduling.